So hello and welcome. My name is Frederick Dunn, and today I'm going to review a product, and I have to tell you legally that it was given to me in exchange for my evaluation of it. But I still want you to watch all the way through because I'm going to talk about something that's important to beekeepers, refractometers. This is a new one that came out. It's by a company called FJDynamics, and this is their quality control inspection card that they send here, but it also shows where it comes from. This thing is made in China. No doubt. These are all the particles and pieces that come with it. Pipettes, you have your USB-C charger, everything else. They say it's a pocket refractometer, which is true. Fits right in your pocket. It's about 3 3/8 inches long, and it's only 7/8 inches in width, and you need an app. That's right. You're going to have to use your phone if you want to use this pocket refractometer in order to determine water percentage of your honey. So they say a pocket size, temperature, compensation, which means it sets its temperature so that it reads correctly, 0 point correction, so you can zero it out with distilled water, and supposedly 30 day standby power if it's fully charged. Now, before I did this review today, I charged it overnight. USB-C, just use your standard phone charger if you have one. We have to go to the app store here, and I started to type it out. Difluid is the name of the app. And so when I type that in, look, there it is, shows up. That's always a good sign if it shows up. It says it's good for everyone, so all ages. So I'm going to click install here. And then, of course, it's going to download 12.32 megabytes and verified by Play Protect. That's always a good sign, too. So let's open it. Here we go. Difluid. Look, it was the same logo that's on the packaging that it came in. That's a good sign, too. Turn on the device, because I want to cover how to pair it with your phone, because without your phone, you're not going to read water percentages, because all this thing does is read bricks, for example. That doesn't help me. If I'm testing honey, I want to know what the water percentage is straight up. That's all I care about, really. So I'm going to show you how well it works, and I'm going to make comparisons to two other refractometers that I use, including those that are used by professionals. So do you want to allow them to determine the position of nearby devices? Yeah, I do, while I'm using it only. And then here it is. Look up at the top there, DFT, TDG, and so on. It already shows 92% battery power. Interesting, because I charged it all night long. Now we're going to zero it out. Zeroing, no liquid. That's right. So I'm going to have to add a liquid. What do you think we should add? Distilled water, of course. And I'm using one of the pipettes that came with it for that purpose. Distilled water. Look at it. By the way, the water is at the same temperature as the device, and the other devices that we're going to evaluate are also the same temperature. Now let's zero it out. Oh, it says it's zeroing. And you're going to find out. I'm not super excited about the app, and the app is just as important as the unit itself because it all has to work together. So the unit's on, it says 0.00% bricks. And so this thing can be used to test a lot of other things, but the only thing I care about is honey water percentage. Look at the bottom here, lower left. It says 20.3 Celsius. You can get into it and change that to Fahrenheit, which I'm going to do in a minute. Let me hit this little green button there to get it going. I also went to the device instructions on their website. Guess what? That page doesn't work. And you go to the official website, they want to sell you all kinds of other stuff. Now that green light comes on. When you see that, you know that it is refracting light. So light either passes through, that's a normal incident angle, or it refracts, which means it angles through the light at an other than normal incident angle, or it reflects. Transmits, refracts, reflects. And you click on the honey here, because that's what we want to know about. Percentage of water content on honey. Now here's the thing. It shows up as honey on your phone. It does not show up as honey on the sensor itself, which would be super helpful if it did that. There's something else I want you to notice. I'm putting the honey on here. We're going to talk about where that honey came from pretty soon. But look at my phone. It says connecting device. So this was a frequent problem with it. It continually disconnects from the refractometer. That is a minor nuisance, but also I'm going to answer questions about accuracy here today, which we're going to want to know. So anyway, we hit that, and you see that little green light comes on. So it's sensing it, and watch, it's going to read out brick. So 79.90%. That means nothing to me when I want to know the water content. So they also tell you to scan the code, and see that little code that's there on the sticker, which came on the box. That's not the code to scan. You need to actually flip over the pocket refractometer, and there's another code on the back of that. That's the one you scan, and then you can link your app and your phone to the actual device. So look, it's linked up there, top left, and the battery, look, it's already down to 81% charge, and we've only been using this for about 15 minutes. So that's interesting. It says that we would have a lot of time on the battery in standby mode. So I don't know what that means, but anyway, we zeroed it out. So we're at 0% water content. It's rated for honey. If you look at the app on the phone there on the right, and now we're gonna put some honey on it and we're gonna test it out. We're gonna find out where we stand. We want to cover the lens, make sure that no light gets around the honey, and then we're gonna do the test. Now, if you push the button on the FJDynamics sensor itself, it does activate independently, but there again, look what it does. It shows me the bricks. I don't care about that. That doesn't help me. So in order to know the water percentage, I have to click the little green dot on the screen of my phone. And then when you do that, look, it's measuring. What's it measuring? It's measuring honey. Ooh, it's 22.87% water content. If that's true, that honey is guaranteed to ferment. So that's not good. And look where the honey came from. Castle Hives, Lordstown, Ohio. And look at BAUM, whatever that is, B-A-U-M-E, at 40.39%. I'm going to compare this, by the way. Let's compare this reading with a MISCO refractometer. Now, for me, this is the best refractometer I could find anywhere. I've used it for years. This is what state inspectors use, food inspectors, and everyone else. This one tests one thing and one thing only, and that's honey water percentage. So we're going to do it. We're going to test it right here. Also, it has that little cap that covers the dish there because it sets a constant temperature to make sure that the reading is true. We're going to put the exact same honey, which again is at the same temperature as all the instruments. And that's from Castle Hives. Thank you, Brian. And we're going to find out, is this honey really in jeopardy of spoiling? So here we go. 17.4%. That's excellent. That is going to be a nice long shelf life. That honey will not ferment. So we got a problem here. Look at the difference. 17.5% on the left, 22.87% on this unit. So right now it is not looking good for FJDynamics pocket dosimeter. We calibrated it with distilled water, and I'm going to test another type of refractometer. Now this is probably one of the cheapest ones you can get. I'm going to put links to all of these, by the way, down in the video description. Even though FJDynamics gave me their unit, they just gave me a link to their website, so you can go to that and check their stuff out. But I'm going to link all the others here so you can do comparisons. This is your cheapest refractometer, and it's going to give you a good accurate reading, by the way. We already know that that expensive MISCO unit read out at 17.5% water. Let's make a comparison here. Now, we want to put the honey over that entire lens. And remember, it's refracted light, so it comes at other than 90 degree angle. And you can see that this already has a bevel on it. And this requires no batteries or anything. Daylight. That's all you need. We just have to make sure that the honey completely covers that blue area and that there are no air bubbles trapped in there. Look at that. It's good to go. So now we're going to look through it. How am I going to do that? Well, I need special camera gear because I want to get you in there so that you can see it and look at it. That's about 17.6% water. So if you look where the blue engages with that light band there, that's a percent of water. So that is really good. So that means that this very inexpensive refractometer is at 17.6%, and the MISCO, very expensive one, is at 17.5%. They're on par with each other. They're good to go. So we have three refractometers here side by side. Now, it might not be fair to the FJDynamics unit to give it just a one shot. You know, one chance. We should probably take it through again. Look at the top of the app there where it says connecting device. This thing loses connection with a refractometer frequently. So I have to reconnect. So I can hit the little search button there on the top right, and that means it searches for the unit, and it tells you to make sure that the unit's on so you can do it. But another thing I want you to notice, look at the temperature, 32 degrees Fahrenheit. What's going on there? So it went from, it bounces all over from the 60s to the 70s, and now down to 32 degrees Fahrenheit, which is very interesting to me. And I'm still trying to connect it to the vise. Guess what you have to do? When it gets stuck like this and won't connect, you have to turn it off. It says I'm not connected to the device, and I confirm that. That's right, I'm going to hit that confirm button and say, that's true, we're not connected. So I had to get out of the app. Get out of the app, this is what the app looks like. I'm going to make sure the FJDynamics refractometer is on. Click on their little app, and it says connecting device. And there it is, it showed up. Yay, I'm back in it. But look, it says bricks there. See on my phone? B-R-I-X. So now we have to click on that, and we're going to have to go to the website after we zero it out and test it for honey. So anyway, we zero that. It says during green light comes on, that lets you know that it's actually doing stuff. Your phone is talking to your refractometer. That's helpful. And zero. So good, we're zeroed out. Now let's go to the website. Look there, honey. That's what I want. And now it shifted it to honey. Notice it doesn't say honey on the actual pocket refractometer itself, so that's a little bit annoying. Let's get more of that Castle Hive honey on there and see if we're still at that dangerously high water content according to the FJDynamics refractometer. Now if I click that, it reads on its own again. What's it going to do? Bricks. 80.3%. Now let's go over here to the app itself. And you have to click the little button down at the bottom of your screen. It looks like the green button on the actual refractometer. And then it goes into measurement mode, and you can see that it's communicating because the green light comes on. And now we're at 18.36%. What a jump! So it actually dropped us from a 22% down to 18.36. So I don't think that's very exciting. I don't know what else to tell you. Look at the temperature too. Now it's reading 68.7 degrees Fahrenheit. And we're still connected though. That's new. And look, 77% battery left. So this temperature parameter jumping all over the place. And now I want to save the data, right? So when I click save data, it says I don't have any data to save. So once again, the app, somebody else might be better at it. It says not measured yet, even though it gave me the water percentage, even though it communicated to the unit itself, even though it's still connected to the unit itself. So now we're zeroing it out again. It says there's no liquid, which is true, and I'm going to calibrate it again. So I'm going to put water, and then I'm going to put honey on it. So here we go. This is the honey phase again. Let's see how accurate it is. And we'll see that little green light come on, which will show that it's registering. Oh, it's measuring. Green light. And we're at 18.12. So with all parameters the same, temperature is the same, the unit is the same, the honey is the same, the calibration method is the same, we have spanned 22% water content all the way down to 18% and change. So it's kind of all over the chart. I think between these three, I'm going to have to tell you that if you've got the money and you want a very accurate system, you're actually looking for the MISCO, that blue one on the left. If you want a very accurate system that's manual, that doesn't require batteries and just needs user skills, then you're going to want the manual refractometer. Look, we're at 32 degrees Fahrenheit now. We're back to bricks, which means it lost connection with my refractometer again, and I have to reconnect, and then I have to pick honey, and then I want to get the water percentage. Overall, this rascal is a little finicky. Also, that battery life goes down pretty darn fast. So in less than an hour, it was down to 76% of its battery charge, and it was charged all night. So it's a pocket unit. It's convenient. It's about $159 if you want this pocket unit, and you will have to use your phone. It's not a standalone thing. So I hope you found this review helpful. I want to thank the company for sending it to me, and I see lots of room for improvement here. Thanks a lot. Have a great weekend.